intentions of the deceased family members, Rolanda, Vladimir, Patrick, Dominique, Miorita. A special memory we remember this during this mass, deceased two mayors, Ludovico Badoy and Fernando Concha. Today, in the first reading, we can hear about the conversion of Saint Paul. In the Gospel, Jesus said, "The one who eats my flesh and drinks my blood lives eternal life, and I will raise him on last day." Please all stand for the general sharing. King of heaven, rejoice, alleluia. As risen as he said, alleluia.
Pray for us, God, alleluia.
Rejoice and be glad, O Virgin Mary, alleluia. Let us pray. O God,
the life of Christ and his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, Christ the Lord and the whole world, the grand man of the that through his intercession of the Virgin Mary, his mother, we may be called the glories of eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and now.
reading from the Acts of the Apostles. So, breathing mothers live, trust against their lost disciples, went to the high priest and asked him for letters to the synagogues in Damascus, which would empower him to arrest and bring to Jerusalem anyone he might find, man or woman, living according to the new way. As he traveled along and was approaching Damascus, a light from the sky suddenly flashed about him. He fell to the ground and at the same time heard a voice saying, "Saul, Saul, why do you persecute me?" "Who are you, sir?" he asked. The voice answered, "I am Jesus, the one you are persecuting. Get up and go into the city. There you will be told what to do." The men who were traveling with him stood speechless. They had heard the voice but could see no one. Saul got up from the ground, unable to see, even though his eyes were open. They had to take him by the hand and lead him into Damascus. For 3 days he continued blind, during which time he neither ate nor drank. There was a disciple in Damascus named Ananias, to whom the Lord had appeared in a vision. "Ananias," he said, "here am I, Lord." "Came," he answered. The Lord said to him, Go at once to Straight Street, and at the house of Judas ask for a certain Saul of Tarsus. He is there praying." So was in a vision a man named Ananias, coming to him and placing his hands on him, so that he might recover his sight. But Ananias protested, "Lord, I have heard from many sources about this man and all the harm he has done to your holy people in Jerusalem. He is here now with authorization from the chief priest to arrest any who invoke your name." The Lord said to him, "You must go. This man is the instrument I have chosen to bring my name to the Gentiles and their kings and to the people of Israel. I myself shall indicate to him how much he will have to suffer for my name." With that, Ananias left. When he entered the house, he laid his hands on Saul and said, "Saul, my brother, I have been sent by the Lord Jesus, who appeared to you on the way here, to help you recover your sight and be filled with the Holy Spirit." Immediately, something like scales fell from his eyes, and he regained his sight. He got up and was baptized, and his strength returned to him after he had taken food. Saul stayed some time with the disciples in Damascus, and soon began to proclaim in the synagogues that Jesus was the Son of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news.
Praise the Lord, all your nations. Glorify Him, all your
Go out to all the world and tell the good news.
be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The Jews quarreled among themselves, saying, "How can this man give his flesh to eat?" Jesus said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, so also the one who feeds me on will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unlike your ancestors, who ate and still died, whoever eats this bread will live forever." These things he said while teaching in the synagogue in Capernaum. The Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So, we thank the community for this Mass, especially for the former mayor of Cotabato City, Ludovico Badoy, who is also a graduate of Notre Dame of Cotabato, and also the former mayor of Kalamansig, Medardo, Concha. Now in Cotabato, if you hear the National Avenue or Play Drive, this will be due to Mayor Badoy in recognition of the public contribution to the city on the occasion of the 50th anniversary of the Open Coming. Similarly, also at the Plaza, City Plaza, I don't know now because they have renovated the Plaza. There were two murals there, I don't know if they did again. The first mural will be on the arrival of the Open, the seven pioneers, because they arrived also, not seven of them, but only the first arrival will be about three, so. At the Plaza, the mural of Moncho and Companions on the left side as you enter the Plaza of the Serizal. And then on the right side will be the mural, also arrival of another missionary, and that will be Sharifah Mosuan and the Muslim missionaries. I find that very interesting because on the one side will be the coming of Christianity, all they have come because the Jesuits were here. But in remembrance of the Oblate Communion, the years, that they really developed the Church of Cotabato, and that site was dedicated to the Oblate pioneers, something to behold. But on the other, facing into the arrival of Islam, as if telling each and every one of us that Christianity and Islam are intimately tied to one another. Similarly, also missionaries of the good news and missionary of the Quran, their lives are knitted like a thread, you know what, producing a beautiful tapestry. So that will be the memory of Ludovico Badoy. I would like to say something particular because this will be given to them. The Badoy brothers are very remarkable. And very few still to see brothers like them. The eldest will be Anacleto Badoy, who became Justice of the Court of Appeal. Then the other one will be Judge Badoy, who became the Executive Judge of Cotabato in the court. The other one will be a politician, and that will be Ludovico Badoy, the mayor. And the other one was a nurse, hosted in the regional hospital, caring for the sick. And the last one, the youngest, will be Solomon Badoy, who was also active in development, particularly SPDA, which is the SPDA, become the administrator of SPDA, and many more. They were all decent brothers, they were very decent. I thought they were trained well by the Maris brothers at Cotabato. People like Brother James, I will remember, who trained them in discipline as well as in hard work. They were all decent, they were honest, and public service was their training. And admirable, they did not amass wealth. I don't know, probably they do, but I don't see, but I don't believe so. So, decent brothers who served for the Cotabato city honorably. And we hope to train in our school, in our palaces, people like them. On the other hand, just across the bay, the Morocco will be the peninsula of Kalamansig as well as the Bab. And in Kalamansig, there are two names very famous for people who remember, especially people of my age, that it will belong to the Benaflor and to the Concha. So we who remember names are belonging to particular geography. Concha would always belong to Kalamansig as well as the Bab and the Benaflor. He could serve for 3 terms. After that, he would be mayor for a lifetime. But the new constitution allowed only 3 terms. But he was mayor prior to the constitution, so he was a mayor for a long time. Medardo Concha. Similarly, also, they will not be recognized for the wealth, for the houses, at least the houses and mansions, but service and availability to people. Badoy will be known for anyone who approach him will not be rejected, Muslims, Christians alike, or indigenous people, but always will be greeted with a smile and welcome in his office. Likewise, also Mayor Medardo Concha. So when I was preparing my homily, I said, oh, very appropriate. I just realized I had the wrong last one to do tomorrow. So, tomorrow time, I wish you have the appropriate in Medardo as well as the week. So, you'll be qualified to have written two class, you know, because in the last one tomorrow, I don't know why I made that mistake, but probably because of all my egos, I see. To be taught by the Lord, and that would be Isaiah. So, Isaiah chapter 2. And not only to be taught by the Lord, to listen to the Lord, and to learn from Him. These 3 operative verbs are very good. Taught by the Lord, listen to the Lord, and learn lessons from the Lord. Do that, and we will be drawn by the Father to Jesus. And because we will be drawn to Jesus, we will live honorably. And because we live honorably, though we pass and die, as we die, the least that we have made will be in the hearts of people, and people remember us. Remember the legacy of friendship, love, and service. And these are precisely the values that endure and endure forever. Let us continue our prayer. Let us entrust Christ, our risen Lord, this church and the whole world, Mayor Peak and Mayor Concha, and all the people in need. Let our response to this petition be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Church of Jesus Christ, that his faith and love may not waver in the difficulties and storms of our times. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the community of nations, that they may live in peace and harmony. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For agencies of international aid, for the United Nations and the governments, that they may use all human potentials and all the resources of science and nature to feed the hungry, especially this time of pandemic. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Christian communities, that we may all grow in trusting faith in Jesus Christ, and that His love may move us to live for one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, especially Ludovico Badoy and Medardo, Concha, that they may rest in secure in the love and joy of the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the hunters who died because of the COVID-19 virus. May God welcome them in this kingdom. May God remove the pain among the living. And we need to hold on to hope. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Jesus, our friend, let us remain in your love and warm one another with it, for you are our Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God, for all creation, to your goodness of this bread offer, which has given you an answer, made it to become for us as people.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, to your goodness of this wine to offer, for to the wine walk of human hands it will become for us as a faithful thing.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord God, we ask you to see you do this with sacrifice of your time. Pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and good of His Holy Church.
Amen. Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, and accepting the oblation of this faithful sacrifice, make us an eternal offering to you, we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time of our world, to lord you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, the universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every nun, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of the glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. May God therefore his gift be praying, descended down the spirit upon them in the true form, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, He took the chalice and was more giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink it now. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." And now let us proclaim the mystery of our faith. Christ has died.
Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we will be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and with your Bishop, the clergy, and religious, the people you have gathered around the order of this man. Remember the big and Medardo, whom you have all promised life. Grant that they who are united with your Son in a death like this may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Eugene, and Saint Marcelline, and all the saints who have issued throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. After they were invited to partake of his meal.
Lord, I am not worthy that thee should enter under my roof, but when you say the word, my soul shall be healed.
The Lord, and the Lord, Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you for the gifts of life that we give up near Badoy and near Concha to their families, to the church, and to the community. May through this Mass, give them the life and resurrection. We ask this through Christ.
Amen.
Special thanks this will be sent to the family of the Conchas and the Badoys. So we thank the Badoys, the family, and the Concha for being very good to the church, to the office of Mary Immaculate, to the community.